Assalamu alaikum friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to discuss how to implement genetic algorithms in MATLAB Simulink software. Friends, the genetic algorithm was introduced by John Holland in the early 1970s. It is a search-based algorithm used for solving optimization problems in machine learning. This technique is inspired by Charles Darwin's theory of natural evolution. Let's start to understand the genetic algorithm with the famous quote by Charles Darwin. According to him, it is not the strongest of the species that survives, nor the most intelligent, but the one most responsive to change. Friends, you must be thinking that what is the relationship of this quote with genetic algorithm? The answer to this question is that basically the entire concept of a genetic algorithm is based on the above quotation. To understand this concept, let's take an example. Suppose we have 100 people consisting of 50 men and 50 women. Now suppose all 100 people get married and give birth to other 50 children. These 50 children will have the best qualities of their parents. Now suppose again out of these 50, there are 25 boys and 25 girls. Now these 25 boys and 25 girls are selected for the next process to find the healthiest and intelligent child. For this purpose, these are married again and give birth to 25 other children. Now these 25 children will have again the best genetically surviving qualities of their parents as well as some other good qualities. This process is continued until we get the single child which is the best, healthiest and most intelligent among all. This whole process is known as natural evolution of human. The genetic algorithm basically follows this idea. This algorithm reflects the process of natural selection where the fittest individuals are selected for reproduction in order to produce offspring of the next generation. The process of natural selection starts with the selection of fittest individuals from a population. They produce offspring which inherits the characteristics of the parents and will be added to the next generation. If parents have better fitness, their offspring will be better than parents and have a better chance at surviving. This process keeps on iterating and at the end, a generation with the fittest individual will be found. This idea can be applied for a search problem related to any engineering field or optimization field. We consider a set of solutions for a problem and select the set of best ones out of them. In which we consider a set of solutions for a problem and select the set of best ones out of them. Friends, let's understand the genetic algorithm step by step in order to transform it from biological process to mathematical and optimization process so that we can use it for solving the engineering problems. The genetic algorithm basically consists of 5 steps as given below. Number 1 is the initialization or initial population. In this step, the genetic algorithm starts by generating an initial population. The population consists of a set of individuals in which each individual is a solution to the problem you want to solve. It means that initial population consists of all the probable solutions to the given problem. Here, an individual is characterized by a set of parameters known as genes. The genes are joined into a string to form chromosome. The chromosome is basically the one of the possible solutions. Friends, it is better to recall the basics of biology. We know that cells are the basic building blocks of all the living things. Therefore, in each cell, there is the same set of chromosomes. Chromosomes are basically the strings of DNA as shown in the figure. A chromosome consists of genes commonly referred as blocks of DNA, where each gene encodes a specific solution or quality, for example, hair color or eye color of their parents. Therefore, we can say that each chromosome represents the solution of genes quality encoded in it. Number two step is the fitness function. After the initialization of population, we determine the ability of the individual to compete with the other individuals by using the fitness function. The fitness function determines how fit an individual is, or in other words, how close it is to the best solution. Suppose if we are minimizing the error, then best fittest individual will be that which has the lowest error among all. This is obtained by assigning the fitness score to each individual. This is necessary process because the probability of an individual that will be selected for reproduction or shifted to next step is depends upon the fitness score. Higher the fitness score, higher the chances of being chosen for reproduction and vice versa. Number three step is the selection. In this phase, individuals are selected again for the reproduction of their offsprings. The selected individuals are then arranged in pairs of two to enhance the reproduction. These individuals pass on their genes to the next generation. The main objective of this phase is to establish the region with high chances of generating the best solution to the problem, better than the previous generation. Number four step is the crossover. Crossover is the most significant phase in a genetic algorithm. For each pair of parents to be mated, a crossover point is chosen at random from within the genes. For example, consider the crossover points to be 3 as shown below, in which offsprings are created by exchanging the genes of parents among themselves until the crossover point is reached as shown in the figure. By exchanging the genes among parents, the new offsprings are added to the population as shown below. Number fifth stage is mutation. Now, if you think in the biological sense, are the children produced have the exactly same qualities as their parents? Can you guess the answer? The answer is no. During their growth, there is some change in the genes of children which makes them different from their parents. This process is known as mutation, which may be defined as a random change or improvement in the chromosome, which also promotes the idea of diversity in the population. This mutation occurs to maintain diversity within the population and prevent premature convergence in the mathematical problems. A simple method of mutation is shown in the image below. It can be noticed from the figure that mutation operator adds new genetic information to the new child population. This is achieved by flipping some parameters in the chromosome. This helps to solve the problem of local minimum and enhance the diversification. The offsprings thus produced are again validated using the fitness function, and if considered fit, then will replace the least fit chromosomes from the population. Friends, these are the basic five steps of the genetic algorithm. Now the last step is the termination or stopping criterion. Now the question may arise, how we will get to know that we have reached our best possible solution? The answer to this question is that basically there are different termination conditions which are listed as below. Number one, suppose there is no improvement in the population for over X number of iterations, then we can terminate the program. Number two, we have already predefined an absolute number of generations for our algorithm. When these generations are completed, the program will stop. Number three, when our fitness function has reached a predefined value. In all of the above conditions, it is assumed that genetic algorithm has provided the best solution in the population to our problem. All these steps of genetic algorithms are shown in the form of flowchart as shown in the figure. Friends, let's discuss the real life applications of genetic algorithms. Genetic algorithms can be used for very large applications in different areas such as computer systems, data centers, code breaking, image processing, medical sciences, engineering sciences including electrical, mechanical, civil, electronics, telecommunication, control system, and chemical. and still there are many other fields where genetic algorithms can be applied. Friends, there are many electrical engineering topics where genetic algorithm can be applied, such as economic load dispatch, optimal power flow, load frequency control, automatic generation control, optimal sizing of DG, renewable energy resources such as solar and wind, power system control, as well as power electronic subjects. In short, genetic algorithm can be used to optimize the parameters of PID controller. Therefore, wherever PID controller is used, genetic algorithm can also be used in that problem to optimize its parameter. From this point, you can realize the wide range of applications of genetic algorithms in various electrical engineering topics as well as other field related topics. Friends, in this video, I have discussed the basic introduction of the genetic algorithm. I have discussed the main five steps of genetic algorithm which are necessary to implement it on any engineering related problem in MATLAB software. In the next video, I will teach you how to implement genetic algorithm on any engineering model in MATLAB Simulink software. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.